Very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Chetan, so much of interesting sharing that you did. The important point that you brought in about culture is what I'm going to be focusing on in this little sharing. Culture, I believe, is not about the December music season. It's not about having Kalakshetra in your city. It's not about Kanchipuram saris. Culture is all about the values, beliefs that individuals have and they display collectively, and I think that makes a big difference. And my concern, my biggest concern, is about, therefore, this belief system and the culture of the city. Developing a city is not about just structures. It's also about responses and sensitivity to how we live with each other and amongst each other. You need both structural and social architecture. Just like the structural architect will design the buildings and the facilities, I think the social architect will have to influence the beliefs and the sensibilities of people. So I'm here advocating for the social architect, the transformational leader, which Bhagat talked about. Why am I here? Because I believe in this philosophy, Aham Brahmasmi, and to me, what does it mean? To me, it means that I take responsibility. It means that I create my life, I build it, I choose to lead my life. And this is where the personal leadership comes. In personal leadership, I recognize that I have a choice in the way I take my roles and willing to lead my life. And this choice about roles is about every role that we have. Be it a dad, mom, friend, office employee, citizen, neighbor. And the question is, have you really made these choices? The choice is to be self-aware and influencing, or the choice is to be partially or fully blind. And blindness about the realities and the blindness about the immense potential that each one of us has to influence both ourselves and the social systems. Why do I talk about this self-awareness as an essential part of transforming people's mind and culture? Because when I'm self-aware, when we are self-aware, then we are proactive, we are sensitive, we operate principle-centered, and we operate with surplus mentality. And the question is, in our cultural milieu, in our collective behavior, are we displaying these qualities? Are we not displaying qualities? That is the question. Let me just show how these four factors play. Let's take the first two, proactivity and sensitivity. Let's say on the one hand we have the high proactivity and the high sensitivity. And let's take the counterpoints, low on proactivity, which means either we are reactive or passive. Similarly, low on sensitivity, which means we are self-preoccupied, or in simple terms, selfish, self-centered. Let's look at what happens. You're high on proactivity, but low on sensitivity. The Northeast, this is the world of dictators and controllers. This is the kind of role taking we'll end up doing. You go diagonally opposite, high on sensitivity, but low on proactivity. This is the world of scholars, critiques, and expert commentators. India and our cities have a lot of these people, expert commentators. They have opinion about everything. Typical example, Indian cricket. As per the last count, we have 1,042 expert commentators in cricket, including Mandira Bedi. We are still searching for 11 good players for the country. What do we have here? I think this is the challenge. Largely in our social system, in societies, in cities, you have a lot of spectators and hecklers. People who say, hey, no, things can't happen. What are you trying to do? Kuch badalega nahi, onnum maarada sari, appadiye da irukum. This is a population that we have got to really carry with us, which is a big burden. But what we require is the typical Northwest, transformational leaders, people who can change social systems. These are the people who will make a difference to society, and that is a question to every one of us, not only sitting here, but living in the city. Do you really care? If so, how do you choose to act? Let's take the other two qualities of principle-centeredness and surplus mentality. Again, take the high of the two factors and the low, deficit mentality and convenience-based living. throwing things anywhere that you want. I will only overtake from the left. I will only cross whenever there is a red light. Government, politicians, they have nothing to do with that. It's about this convenience at random attitude. So what do you have? The world of opportunists and manipulators? Because high on surplus mentality, but very, very convenience, personal convenience based. Take the diagonally opposite. This is the world of hoarders and withholders. Lot of conviction of principles, but can never do anything. Can't do is the principle that they operate from. Worst case scenario, eternal consumers, parasites of the system. Khaya jao, consume everything, don't give back anything. What we require is a creator investor. Friends, if this looks too much like an academic model, I would like to play a guessing game with you. Do you recognize the opportunist manipulator in the system? This is the big P. Who is the big P? The typical politician. Do you know the typical hoarder withholder? The big B. Go 10 times, nothing happens. Try the 11th time, romba kashtam sir. Go the 12th time, come back once again. The government official or the typical bureaucrat, the big B. Who is this consumer parasite? The big C. You know who it is? Mr. Citizen. Free this, free that, free that. I believe now free marriages, very soon free husbands, and very soon free children. That's the eternal consumer and parasite. What we require is a creator investor into a system. You think this is some intellectual BS and just concepts and not practical? I want to take you for a few minutes of live experiences and something that has happened in the last 12 months, ladies and gentlemen, and it began last year around the 25th of January 2011. While I was traveling from Kottiwakam towards Valmiki Nagar in Thiruvanmiyur. This is the place, a place where there are three roads around a plot. This is a corner where on the left-hand side you can see a road from Kottiwakam that we are coming in, and then there is a road in front of the Sai Baba temple near Valmiki Nagar, and you can see that on the right-hand side it goes into Jagannathan Street. A beautiful place where traffic flows from all the three sides. And lo and behold, what do I see? A construction coming up. And what kind of a construction? Where looks like a series of kind of either shops or garages, and not even a feet of layoff space. Even a single motorbike standing out there creates traffic chaos. And first of all, God alone knows who gives permission for these kind of things to be built. You know that's a recipe for disaster. I was really taken aback. How can this be tolerated? I was just asking this question. My mother-in-law was with me in the car. She saw that I was getting very worked up. She asked this question, what are you thinking very seriously, Raja? I said, Ma, is this the only way that we will all the time live? Things can happen any which way? I don't believe that. I said, I don't want to give up this without really seeing whether anything can be done about it. A letter and mail started to six people, including the DC, the Commissioner of Police, to the CMDA chairman, to the local panchayat, and of course, to the Deputy Chief Minister, because he was in charge of what you call as local self-governance. The details of this letter I'm not getting into. Personally, I took 2 days off, created the letter, went and handed over to every one of them. Luckily, in CMDA, when I went there, I was very, very fortunate to meet Mr. Kataria, Member Secretary, and he, in audience, within half an hour's time, called the planning engineer, because I'd gone with all the photographs of the place, and he said, please, look into this. It looks like something needs to be done. I was very happy because he called and gave instruction to the engineer. 2 months passed. I was traveling a little bit, came back. Nothing had happened. March end, no action in spite of instructions. The construction continued. And indeed, a set of shops, and you can see this, shutters have come up, and they are all ready for opening up now. I got really livid. I was very angry. And my mother-in-law on the phone from US asked, Raja, enna chupa? I said, unna agala, I hope something will start happening now. I wrote a second letter, and this time I said, I'm going on a protest, and in 10 days, I may choose to go on a hunger strike. Gave the letters to the same set of people. Went to the CMDA office. Mr. Kataria was on a US visit. Mrs. Susan George was there, but I couldn't meet her. But I think she sent an instruction. I met the planning engineer over there who gave me an audience. He said, "Annake anipettan sir instruction." I said, "Okay, please give me a coffee. I'm the petitioner." He waited for 45 minutes. Then he said, "Sorry, sir, instruction kurtum, but I think it has not been carried out at all." I said, "I'm willing to wait till evening today, 5:30. Please give me a fresh instruction." I waited until the evening, and I got an instruction. And they said they will send it off to the panchayat union office at Chitalapakkam within the next few days' time. By that time, I was not too sure. So I decided that I will go to the Chitalapakkam BDO office on the coming Monday. I went there. Ladies and gentlemen, I should tell you now that the world is not as simple as we think. Here is a gentleman who gives approval for building permissions for thousands and thousands of people worth thousands of crores of rupees. And you know what kind of an office he lives in and works from? It is an asbestos roof, 75-year-old office, where he has got old saris as curtains, plastic chairs in front of him, and no AC, nothing. And we talk about our comfort levels. Look at a poor government official's working conditions level. But he was an amazing guy. He said, "All right, sir, what is it that you have come for?" And we met. We met, and he looked at the documents. He has still not got the CMD instructions. He said, "The pathale, you know, thodu sir, serial enna. I'll be there." I said, "When?" "Another 2 months?" He said, "Within 48 hours. I said, "Is there a promise?" He said, "Yes." And we waited. Believe me, this is where I want to talk about the difference. Mr. Ravichandran came within 48 hours, and he's the gentleman out there. And Mr. Ravichandran to me represents what we are talking about, the shift of the big B. If he was a big B earlier at the bottom level, he became, in my opinion, a builder of faith and confidence and made a huge difference. But yes, you can applaud him. Just like it took 2 months from Mr. Kataria to the planning engineer, it took one more month from Mr. Ravichandran's level to the final executive officer. And then at last, on 24th of May, ladies and gentlemen, I must show you what happened. And Mr. Rajendran, with his team, pasting of the stop construction notice by the CMDA people out there. The illegal construction was completely stopped, and that is the pasting of the notice that takes place. What really was required during this period? Roughly about 3 full days of my time and my determination to find out whether in this country, whether in this city, you have to give up your hopes and live. And I was not willing to give up my hopes. As simple as that. Having done that, my dear friends, the lesson that I learned was very simple. That building any system calls for both dedication and discipline. And discipline is not some kind of a magic idea. To me, the formula of discipline is 2E plus 2P. Enable and ensure doing the right things. Prevent and prohibit doing the wrong things. And I think I took a little step in preventing and prohibiting doing the wrong things. But I want to tell you, there are some amazing people who are working on enabling and ensuring the right things, including Mr. Nirmal out here. So what is dedication? In this audience, my friends, there is a gentleman sitting, and that is a photograph. His name is Mr. Balasubramaniam. For 14 years, he is running an organization called Nallur Vattam. And I got introduced to him in a very interesting way when you were part of the Anna Hazare rally. And I was taken aback when I saw that in Kodambakkam, in a particular area, he was doing what he calls as street initiatives. 3 hours on a Sunday, 20, 30 people coming together, taking over the street, completely cleaning up the place in every possible way, involving the people out there, taking statistics and census, creating a community awareness program. And believe me, when I participated, there was no question of holding back my joy at all. Dedicated, absolutely unselfless kind of people, youngsters, and he has been doing that kind of an initiative for the last 14 years. Mr. Balasubramaniam is in our audience today. And the other thing I want to tell you, he looks very simple. He looks extremely simple. But in the last 3 months, I have seen that he has organized with various NGOs and public activists 3 meetings with the mayor of the city, and it has culminated very beautifully in an initiative on day before yesterday. 25th of March. It's called the 6x6 kind of a program. And why I have marked that little part over there? The most important part of that 6x6 program, Suya Kattu Patal Chennai Uyarvu, developing Chennai because of self-discipline. And you know what is the self-discipline that we have talked about? Dear friends, remember, during our school and college days, we get roughly 900 days of leave. When you're an employee, you get every year 30 days of privileged leave. The only question that we're asking is, can you, for the sake of the society, for the country, take 4 days of patriotic leave and dedicate your time in the best interest of your city, your neighborhood, or for your country? Simple question as that. Tell me, sir, is there anybody in this room who has not stood in front of, a mirror at least for a few seconds today? Please raise your hand. Not a single hand will go up. You know why? Simple. Because we care about ourselves. But who cares for personal space? Very few people like Mr. Balasubramaniam. Ladies and gentlemen, therefore it's all a question of our willingness to work on the social space. What are we willing to do about it? About the nation space, about the common space, our streets and our cities. Therefore, one of the important things that we have talked about is that there will be, out of the 6 resolutions that individual will take, we are talking about dedicating every month 4 hours for the sake of civic work, social work, locality work. That's what I've marked out there. Namadu Chennai, Namadu Purupu. Our city is our responsibility, is the initiative that Mr. Balasubramaniam, and the person who presided over this is none other than the mayor of this city, Mr. Saide Doraiswamy. Ladies and gentlemen, I consider that he is a Karma Yogi. Today we are lucky we have a good mayor, some good counselors. Talk to my counselor, Mr. Rajaram. Epa sir, meet panna. Morning 6 o'clock, sir. Every morning 6 o'clock is available in the local office for meeting. Let us not oversimplify. Let's not believe that everything is difficult. Let's not paint every politician and the government official as black. There are Ravichandrans, there are Rajarams, there are also Balasubramaniams. Let's go beyond being just critics and observers in the system. It's not easy, but it's our world. Let's make it together a better world. It's not easy, but it's our nation. We need to act. It's not easy, but it is Namma Chennai. It is Namma Purupu. It is really up to us. If you care and if you choose to act, let's not just survive. Let's lead our life. Let's build our city. Your city, gentlemen. Thank you so much for your time.